During the launch of the 2023 State of Uganda Population Report by the National Population Council, it was revealed that unlike in other countries on a global scale where the demographics of children have been falling, Uganda has had the opposite, which has resulted in a high dependency ratio.
Developed countries already have relatively old populations and are coming to the end of the dividend period of rising proportions in the working ages.
Uganda has a high population growth, registering a 3% increase annually. Important to highlight, this has had drastic effects to the country's economy over the years, majorly affecting the country's GDP.
I'm sure you have heard that Uganda has a very young age structure. Whichever measure that you want to use, whether you want to use those below 15, below 30, those 18 to 30, we all know that Uganda has a very young age structure. And we know that the age structure of any population is driven by our past. As we speak now, our GDP growth rate this year is expected at 5.2%. Now, where you have a population growing at 3.2%, this high level of fertility rate, most of the GDP growth rate is being consumed by this high growth rate in the population.
Themed mindset change for a favorable population age structure, a prerequisite for wealth creation. Stakeholders say that a lot has to be done to enable this aspect, majorly with central inclusion of youths in the development agenda and scaling them.
With a population of over 46 million people, of whom 75% are below the age of 30 years, Uganda has a very young population.
So Uganda's primary strategy for harnessing the demographic dividend revolves around ensuring that adolescents are healthy, they are properly educated, and are appropriately skilled to seize the employment opportunities.
The guest of honor at the event, Pakwach Woman Member of Parliament, Jane Avoru Pachuto, reiterated the urgency of mindset change amongst Ugandans, saying that it is pivotal in achieving the triumph for development of the country which it seeks after.
However, many of our people have a fixed mindset, believing that their abilities and talents are predetermined. That limits their potential, making it hard for them to work and get out of poverty.
At the climax of the event, notable journalists in the line of population reporting were awarded, including Vision Group's Prosina Ndutu and Jackie Achan, as the Best Print Journalist and Journalist of the Year, respectively. Among other suggestions to visualize wealth creation is to end sexual violence on young girls and women who bear children at an early age of 13, and to disempower polygamous ideas, which creates a leeway for competition among wives to have more children than their counterparts in marriage. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.